What up, boys, and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we are looking at a farm that has always been my most hated farm, and we're talking about Sky Shards. So most of you guys already know about the Sky Shard farming, and the reason why I'm making this video now is that it's actually pretty decent. And also, since I never do this farm because I hate it, which I will explain why, it doesn't really matter that there's more competition on this farm, right? So the reason why I hate the farm is because back before I started making YouTube videos and also live stream myself gold farming, I was still gold farming. I just wasn't like creating any content. And every single gold farmer back then was farming in this zone right here, Vale of Eternal Blossom, and they were all doing like the ghoul light keys, every single one of them. And I was like, shit, dude, I make more gold than these guys, and I don't do the same farm for like 12 hours a day. And that's where the whole thing started, with like a lot of other reasons too, right? But like, that was the main thing. Like, I was like, shit, dude, there's other ways of making gold, because I was doing it myself. And I've never done the farm ever since. So Ski Aussie convinced me into trying it, because the price of what we're farming, which is, by the way, this mount right here, is now 25,000 gold. That is the region market value. On my realm, it goes for 21.5. On your realm, it might be 40,000 gold. It might be 12,000 gold. So I decided that if I can get one on average and get like roughly 25,000 gold an hour on only the mount, that would be considered decent, right? 25k is pretty much the same as you get in a super efficient group if you do the raw gold farm in Gorgrond. So we went ahead and we did it. And as you guys can see, the location is down here at the Tushen Burial Ground, right? And there's actually, I'm not sure if they left. No, they're still here. These guys. Like, normally I would say that these are multi-boxers, but they were like jumping around like this. So I'm not sure. It might be multi-boxing, because I can see that this guy is looting now. So I'm guessing that they're looting every 20 minutes. And they might be just a casual guy multi-boxing. Normally, when they bought it, they have these automated replies and they walk in like these really scripted patterns. So most likely this is a guy multiboxing it. He's, however, not covering all these marks. So he has like a budget setup, not a full setup. I'm going to fly a bit up so you guys can get a better overview of the marks in the five-man farm. So the skull over here, and then you have the X down here, the blue mark, and then the green, and then moon. That's like how we did it. So it's super RNG. And in order to get the mount, you need to get 10 of this one, the Sky Shard. So I actually, we did it for 1 hour and I got 11 shards. So that's just enough to get one mount. And the first 20 minutes after we looted, I got one. And then we did another 20 minutes of killing and I got two. And then on the last one, I got 8. So RNG is a big factor on this one. It's absolutely insane. But I got over one mount in 1 hour. And I also got this epic cloak with an okay-ish value. So that's like where you do the farm. And how you do it is that you place your toons like in a five-man group. If you can get five people, you place them on the markers. And then you just kill mobs for 20 minutes. And then you loot. So it's like the most frequent asked question is, when I kill for 20 minutes without looting, is student, won't the loot despawn? And if you weren't aware, basically when you kill mobs, if I kill this guy and he drops just gray items or maybe a green item, he will despawn in like 3 minutes roughly. However, if any mobs in the game drop a blue item or an epic item, the mob won't despawn for half an hour, which is why we kill shit for 20 minutes to maximize the time we spend on killing. And then after killing for 20 minutes, we loot. Then we go back, kill for 20 minutes, fly around and loot. And then we do it the last time. So full hour, loot only 3 times during 1 hour of farming. So that is the tactic on this one. You could do like the 2-minute tactic and you're also going to get Spirit of Harmony. I got 7 Spirit of Harmony. And that is looting 3 times. So obviously, if you loot every 2 minutes, you will get more raw gold, way more Spirits of Harmony. But we were only after the mount, and you get way more Sky Shards if you kill for 20 minutes and then loot. So once you have 10 of these, as the item says, you click on it, 10 of them, and you combine it into a sky crystal. Now, once that is done, there's going to be Alani, a giant fucking dragon flying around in the zone. And he has had his respawn timer nerfed right now. And only the guy using the item gets the mount. So you pretty much just got to wait until you have the sky crystal, fly around to find Alani, the big dragon, click on the item, and the mount gets just instantly put in your bags. So that is how it works now. And then you throw it up on the auction house, you sell it for 20, 25,000 gold, you're super happy, you go back, you farm it again. And that's it. I just wanted to make a video on this farm, in case, I'm guessing that most of you guys haven't done it, or you kind of forgot about it when prices were really bad at some point, because at some point you could... One guy could spend his sky crystal and five people could get the mount, and they were like super cheap, and now they've gone up in value again. So it's actually a way more reliable farm to do now than it used to be. And that is pretty much it for the video. If you guys haven't already, you can still get the 0 to 10 million gold guide for 50% off using code Shadowlands. Means a lot to me when you guys buy it. To everyone who has bought it, thank you so much for supporting my content. And that's it. I will see all of you guys back in on tomorrow's video. But until then, bye-bye.